Hey there, I'm Darren. Today we're going on a journey to the Slate Islands, the Isle of Seil and the Isle of Lynn, 16 miles south of Oban, just off the west coast of Scotland in the Hebrides. So let's pack a kit and travel together. Hello and welcome to Seil, the first of the Slate Islands. Normally come here before you go on to Ling and Easdale and the other Slate Islands. Just come over the Clachan Bridge, which is also known as the Bridge over the Atlantic. The only bridge over the Atlantic. I think it was built in 1791, finished. Behind us here is the pub. Now, forgive my Gaelic. I believe it's called the Tuí an Triosh, which roughly translates as House of the Trousers. So after the Jacobite uprising, 1745, when they wanted to go back over to the Scottish mainland, they used to pop in there, take off their kilt, put on some trousers, and go back over to the mainland there. And when they came back from the mainland when we gathered there the bits and bobs, they popped into that public house, put back on their kilts, and then they went back to on their way to their own abodes. Because back in the 1700s, obviously it was forbidden to be seen or wear the clan colours or your kilt. Okay. Welcome to the Isle of Ling. There's a short little crossing over here. And now we're going to go up here and about a mile or so and find somewhere to camp. Catch you later. So here we are, welcome back. We're now on the Isle of Ling. I've not done one of these for a month or so. I've been busy doing other things and not had the time to get out and get camping. So I'm pleased that I have, even though the weather not ideal conditions, could be better, but hey ho, here I am, and we'll just crack on. The weather, well, it's going to be like this for the next couple of days at least, so hopefully get the tent up before it comes down, chucks down again. That's my main aim tonight. So these islands are called the Slate Islands because they roofed the world. That's what they say. Slate from these islands went to all four corners of the world to do the roofs. So all over. And that, for the last 150, 200 years or so. Then it came into a decline in the 1960s. So here we are in the luxury accommodation for tonight. I have a folding up roll mat as well tonight, and that's obviously going to keep us insulated from the ground. I've got my normal Thermarest followed by my Rab sleeping bag there tonight. I brought that fold up roll mat because I wasn't sure what it was going to be like, so I thought may as well just bring that just to be on the safe side. It doesn't weigh anything and it's going to keep us insulated a bit more from the ground. Okay, then pop the Thermarest on top. Yeah, so that's it. Beautiful. Sleeping bag. Then I've got my Bergen to the side, my water, beer, and my cooking stuff. And that's it. A couple of flip-flops. If I want to go for a call of nature.
So let's get on with tonight's delights then. What do I have? Chicken tikka and rice boiling the bag. Beautiful, that sounds magical. I'll have that for my tea. Let's get it set up. Days. Get the feet out, pop it down, rest at the side there. Dee dee dee, dee 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 dee. Up. Pop it into the oven. There we go. Where? Da da da. Get the windshield on. Just a little bit, there we go. Make sure they're in a bit. Pop the windshield on over the top of it. Make sure you put the feet out so the cup can sit in. Cup It's in Magic Lake. That's it. So leave a bit at the top that you're going to grab a hold of when it finishes. Push the food to the bottom. Squish the food to the bottom. That's it. So you've got the food in the bottom. And the top is nice and flat. And squash in the sides. Pop it in. Let's get some water on. There we go. It pop this on the top and instead of a nutcracker, that's it done. Right. Happy days, woohoo, magical. Yippee doo, dee dee dee, shooby doo be dooby doo. Let's have a can. Tonight's beverage is Brewdog Elf. It's coming up to Christmas. Why not? Is it a bit early? Oh, I'll leave that till for all the comments and such. Tell us if it's early. Sort of a nutcracker. 4.5%. Let's get that down, my Gregory Pecker. Cheers, the Slate Islands. Happy days. Oh, that's alright, that. For a lager. Can he? The flames, you get awesome flames. Currently licking up around Hexham there at the minute. Oh, lower. Dee dee dee. Where is? Da da da. Dee dee dee. Dee dee dee. Pincers. Pinch, 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 pinch. Nope. What about these again? These are good cups of coffee, by the way. Just a case of opening up this sleeve. Opening up this sleeve here. Oh, that's it done, Hexham. Yay! Happy days, that's hot. Let's get them flames out. There we are then. Done. That's them out. So as I was saying, these coffees are outstanding. It's a case of just filling up the coffee. Pouring it into there. It's already got coffee in. Pour water in. As it says, the more water you put in, the less stronger it is. and then leave it to brew for a while, and then pour out the little pourer. Just take out my my milk. What's that? Pour this in while I'm waiting for while I'm eating. Then I can. Last dribbles. Let's get it all in there. There we go. It's got like a fresh seal on one of them sandwich bags. Just do that along the top and that's it in. You can see how much water there. Nice and strong. So that's it in there. Sealed at the top. Just let it brew. Pop that there back on the top. Oh, that's nice and hot, hot. Chicken tikka. There's nothing wrong with frying your own steaks and such, but these are very good, just convenient food, just like in the house. If you can't be arsed cooking your dinner, we're in the microwave. Well, the microwave in this idea, it's a pile in the bag. Looks alright. Do you have a look? Ah, dear glow tikka. That's good. Really good. Nothing like having a Ruby Murray and a chin of beer. Cheers. Good luck. And the thing is with these, you can use them two or three times as well. Coffee stays in there, so all I need to do when I do my water again, open it up again, pour it in and let it brew. Job's a good one. Happy days. Stir. That there was magical. That's good brew. Good brew. So here we are then, it's only 10 to 5 and it's absolutely pitch dark outside. So here we are, and this will probably be this dark until about 7, 8 o'clock in the morning. So, began raining again as you can hear. But it's not cold, it's quite nice and warm. Well, I wouldn't say it's warm, that's lying. It's quite, it's not cold, it's warm, yeah. I haven't got a warm jacket on yet, so I'm not feeling as though I need it. I'm going to use it as a pillow to sleep on later. I've just got my base layer on with nothing on underneath. Just sitting chilling. I've been busy for the last month or so, unable to get out and do some camping and getting at one with the old nature and such. But it's good to be back out. Did look outside, seen the rain, I was humming and hawing. But I'm pleased I did come out in the end, I'm pleased. It's that initial, I don't want to go out in the rain sort of scenario. But when you're out in it, or out in the bad weather, it's not too bad, to be fair. It's nice, gets you back to basics, contemplating yourself, and just, you know, having a word with yourself and that. Makes you think. And allows you to get some headspace, which is always good. Last weekend was Remembrance Weekend. I was working. I didn't go to the cenotaph, or I didn't go to the monument in Auburn. Just did my own little silence in my head for the happy day. So then here we are. We haven't travelled too far today. I'm pleased you've come with us. We've come, we're on, camping out on, this is the Isle of Ling. We've come from Seal, we're on Ling. We've travelled some 15, 16 miles south of Auburn. And here we are. Travelled over the, over the Atlantic Ocean, that's where we've travelled from. Yep. We're over the sea, over the ocean. Quite funny. I think the rain sounds have died off there, which is good. Oh, the hell. Have we got flies in here? Where is he? Where have they come from? Answers on a postcard. Morning. Well, it is it's a lot of time. Oh, that was 6. Still dark. So morning from the beautiful Isle of Ling. There's the morning. Beautiful colours, sunrise. It's been, obviously first light was about, I think 25 past 7. Sunrise is meant to be about 10 past 8. So that'll be the start of the sunrise. View down there, absolutely sensational.
don't think you're going to get much looking at them dark clouds up there. However, it's trying to pop out up there as well. Got some boats and such down in the bottom in the sound there. Really good. Proper magical view in the morning. Really good. Happy days. Anyway, catch you later. So down there was last night's camping spot. Over to the left. Awesome. So off to the ferry now, back over to Seal, and then we'll, when I get there, we'll see what the crack is. Here we are, getting closer to the ferry port. Just thought I'd show you the lovely scenery behind me still. Nice.